That's the news. Bob Schieffer sitting in for Dan Rather. Good night.
This is CBS.
Coming up on News Channel 5, serving on the grand jury cost him his job, but justice has prevailed. The latest on the man accused in the Antioch murder case, and patients keep walking away from a Waverly, Tennessee nursing home. And a special friendship they have walking horses in common. The 6 o'clock report is next.
Long day, huh? Bet it's gonna take something extra special to get you out of the house tonight. Hey, listen to what we've cooked up at Bonanza Restaurant.
Enjoy our club sirloin dinner, charbroiled just the way you like it, and specially priced only $4.99. Every dinner entree includes the Fresh-tastic food bar with soups, salads, breads, and desserts absolutely free.
So don't just sit there.
The extra don't cost extra at Bonanza.
Once again, the last letter of the alphabet is the last word in sports cars. The new Z from Nissan.
This is the News Channel 5, 6 o'clock report with Chris Clark.
Good evening, everyone. It was a question of justice in more than one way. Mickey Lassiter says he was only doing his civic duty by serving on the county grand jury. The company he worked for thought differently, and eventually they fired him. Lassiter got his day in court today, and our Larry Brenton was there.
We're here in case number 5 now.
Mickey Lassiter is a member of the Davidson County Grand Jury, the panel that decides who should be indicted for criminal charges. Like all 13 members, Lassiter is paid $10 a day. The grand jury meets for 4 months, 3 hours a day, 3 days a week.
I'm proud to serve as a juror, and if I'm ever called again, I will do it no matter where I'm working.
That's the hitch. Lassiter was fired by his employer, Forklift Systems, on Elm Hill Pike, because he said company officials thought it took too much time away from his job.
This is a clear case of a person in a business regarding the money more than he does justice. Simple as that.
Charles Hardy, Forklift's president, admitted during a hearing today that repeated efforts had been made to get their employee off the jury duty, all unsuccessful. At one point, Lassiter had even been demoted from his electrical mechanics job to sweeping floors and cutting grass.
In mid-June, Lassiter was sent here to the Equity Group plant to work on some forklifts. While repairing one of the forklifts, he accidentally hit and ruptured a sprinkler system. 2 days later, he was fired.
Lassiter said all along he was really fired because of his grand jury duty. Judge Tom Shriver agreed and ordered Forklift to pay Lassiter $1,100 in back pay. The company also agreed to give him back his job, but the company's president apparently was not happy about it as he left the courtroom. He refused to comment. The company's lawyer was asked what kind of a future Lassiter might have at Forklift.
Now, whether Mr. Lassiter intends in good faith to continue working and do what he's supposed to do is up to Mr. Lassiter. It's not up to us. We've agreed to take him back.
I think it'd be very short term. As soon as they can justify getting rid of me again without being back in court, I believe that's what they'll do.
Mickey Lassiter is protected as long as the grand jury is still meeting, but it's over next week for him, and his job may not be far behind. Larry Breton, News Channel 5.
Two murders within 1 week, one in Florida and one here in Antioch. But is there a connection between those two murders? Well, that's what Metro Police and Florida authorities are investigating. As Dan McDonald reports, the two murder victims were both women from Antioch.
36-year-old Alan Preston Brooks of Antioch is behind bars in Florida, a suspect in two murders. Brooks is wanted in Tennessee for the murder of his former girlfriend, 26-year-old Amy Payton. She was beaten and shot last Sunday in her Antioch apartment.
There was some written material that we believe was written by him, and it implicates himself in the murder, and also that he was going to take his own life.
Brooks was arrested Friday in Daytona Beach. On Saturday, an employee found the body of 26-year-old Terry Lynn Bonds of Antioch in a room at this Daytona Beach motel. She was shot in the head and wrapped in a sheet and had been dead for several days. Brooks' car was found in the parking lot at this same motel. Despite all the coincidences, Metro Police are still trying to determine what the connection is between Terry Lynn Bonds and Ellen Brooks. It's still not clear how they would have known each other here and why they would have ended up in the same Daytona Beach motel at the same time. But Brooks is not the only suspect. Bonds checked into the motel with a man who doesn't fit Brooks' description. She told the clerk they were newlyweds on honeymoon and paid cash. Florida authorities are now searching for that man. Bonds had an extensive criminal record, including numerous arrests for drugs and prostitution. She was indicted in the armed robbery of an Antioch bank in February. It is the same bank where Amy Payton, Brooks' alleged victim, worked as a teller.
It seems on the surface to be very, very complicated, and that's what we're trying to do today is unravel it, and hopefully we can, and see if any of this is connected up with the two murder cases, somehow connected, at least with the same suspect.
Although it seems unlikely, police say this all could turn out to be simply a bizarre coincidence. They're not taking any chances. For now, Brooks will remain in a Florida jail cell while detectives try to figure out who killed Terry Lynn Bonds. Dan McDonald, News Channel 5.
Metro Police today searched the home of William Clark Duggar, the man accused in the murder of a social worker and the kidnapping of a Nashville businesswoman. No word on what police recovered, if anything, from Duggar's home. And at a Nashville church this morning, a memorial and a remembrance for that social worker, Robin Boswell. Friends and family came to the Woodmont Hills Church of Christ to remember her. Boswell was murdered last week in Percy Warner Park, the victim of William Duggar. The kidnapping of businesswoman Andrea Conti. Boswell was well known for her work with the troubled children and in 1988 was named Teacher Counselor of the Year in Tennessee. Duggar remains in the Metro Jail. And the restaurant employee shot and wounded by a fellow worker last week remains in very critical condition with a head wound at Vanderbilt. Bridget White is 3 months pregnant, her baby still alive. Co-worker Carrie Farmer is accused of shooting her. Some new information tonight on another murder investigation, a shooting back on March on Music Row. You remember the case. March the 9th, 23-year-old Kevin Hughes was killed and another man wounded when a gunman shot them on 16th Avenue South. Well, News Channel 5 has learned that the shooting may have been a case of mistaken identity. Sources say the victim looked a lot like another man who the bullet may have been intended for. In addition, the car Hughes and his companion were riding in looked like the car for the intended victim. Hughes worked for the music industry magazine Cashbox, and at one time, it was thought his shooting might have been industry-related. But sources now tell us that the current theory is that it had nothing to do with the music industry or Music Row. There have been no arrests in this case. Wilson County Sheriff Terry Ash is home this evening after spending 2 days in the hospital. Ash was struck by lightning on Saturday while doing farm work on his tractor. The 40-year-old sheriff says he's hurting a bit, but otherwise, he's okay. Now, let's take a first look at our weather. Here's Ron.
Well, Chris, no, not a whole lot of lightning in our area this afternoon. Most of it has been occurring up through the Great Lakes in the Midwest. Torrential downpours moving through parts of Illinois and Indiana as we speak. Other scattered showers and thunder showers have been working along the Gulf Coast, as you see. And there are some scattered showers and thunder showers developing over Missouri and Arkansas. A quick check at National Weather Service radar now shows indeed a line of thunder showers extending across southern Illinois up into Indiana. There's some other activity down here near Savannah, Tennessee, and also in the upper Cumberland Plateau. But my forecast for tonight for us looking like this. We're going to see nothing worse than just partly cloudy skies with a few scattered thundershowers in the area and an overnight low of about 73 degrees. Chris?
Thanks, Ron. Coming up next on the 6 o'clock report, why people in Franklin, Kentucky are steamed over their new steam plant and problems at a Waverly nursing home. The patients just keep walking away. We'll be right back.
I know the United Way does some good, but I got plenty to worry about myself. I got groceries to buy. Pretty soon, my kids are going to need new tennis shoes, you know? Oh, and my wife, she's got that redecorating bug again. Look, somebody will take care of it.
With you, there's a way. Without you, there isn't. United Way of Middle Tennessee.
Hey, don't worry. It's your five-star Honda dealer's Be Happy Buy Honda Summer Sale on all Hondas, going on now through August 31st.
Don't worry, be happy, buy Honda.
Get behind the wheel of this sporty two-door Accord LXi Coupe with all options including automatic transmission. Not 20, not 18, only 15.3. That's $10,000 less than a comparable BMW 325i. Plus, your good trade and our best deal will lower your cost even more. But hurry, sale ends August 31st at your five-star Honda dealers. Jenkins and Wynn, Darrell Waltrip, Trickett, Honda Car Village, and Capital.
Woo-wee! I never saw a warehouse this big.
Yeah, looks like everything's on sale, too.
H.H. Gregg has this place packed to the ceiling.
No wonder they're having a warehouse sale.
Now get this RCA 26-inch cable-ready stereo color TV with remote. Just $399, including free next-day delivery from H.H. Gregg.
Did you see that?
We just drove through another time zone.
Woo-wee! Never saw a warehouse this big.
Yeah, I'll bet the savings are just as big, too.
Now Red Lobster tempts you like never before with King Crab Legs, sweet snow crab, luscious dungeness. It's our Crab Lovers Festival, starting at an incredible $6.95. Give in to temptation. 8 great crab and seafood platters you'll love, starting at just $6.95. The Crab Lovers Festival, now at Red Lobster. And kids get shrimp, a complete meal, just $1.95.
How would you feel if you had a loved one in a nursing home and he or she managed to leave the facility without anyone knowing about it? Well, that's exactly what is happening at the Humphreys County Nursing Home. In fact, it happened 3 times in the last month. Tom Gasparoli reports some family members and state officials want to know why.
When 76-year-old Bertha Little disappeared earlier this month, it caused a panic. For 9 hours, searchers scoured the woods around the Humphreys County Nursing Home. Finally, Ms. Lee was found, not far from the facility, bruised and frightened, but safe. The woman had walked out the front door around 6 in the morning, and nobody noticed. On the night of August 10th, another nursing home resident walked out the front door. She was found 30 minutes later at the hospital emergency room next door. That's not all. On August 2nd, 84-year-old Teely Sherrill walked out the front door unsupervised. Ms. Sherrill headed toward a busy highway, but stumbled and fell against a fence before she was found. She ended up with a baseball-sized knot on her head and bruises all over her face.
I couldn't imagine someone falling like that and having the knot on the head the way she had it and the way she looked. It was hard to believe.
Debbie McCullough wants to know how her great aunt managed to walk away at night without anybody stopping her. The front door at the nursing home has a bell that rings when the door opens, but the bell is not very loud. Nursing home administrator Stephen Lee said all 3 incidents occurred during shift changes, when a lot of people are coming in and out the front door.
I don't know why it happens during those time frames, but it's a difficult situation.
State investigators say they knew about the case where a woman was missing from here for 9 hours, but they had not been informed about the 2 other incidents, including the case where Teely Sherrill was injured. Investigators say they should know about every unusual incident, especially when a resident is badly hurt. Even though this nursing home has alarms on the side and back doors and a bell on the front, the administrator admits he needs a better security system to protect the residents day and night. In Waverly, Tom Gasparoli, News Channel 5.
Franklin, Kentucky is suing the manufacturer of its $2 million garbage incinerator. The suit claims that KDU Incorporated has designed a defective garbage-to-steam incinerator. The facility is supposed to burn 75 tons of trash per day, but officials say it never worked.
We were promised one product. That product was not delivered. We had to pay for the product $2 million. We've suffered damages because we didn't get what we bought.
Boone is an attorney representing Franklin. Boone says the incinerator burned itself up. Franklin shut down the plant just 2 years after it opened and now pays to have his garbage hauled away.
It was hot enough in here to make its own steam this weekend.
Yeah, we didn't need a garbage incinerator. Just leave it out in the sun, right?
Well, it would get a little bit ripe, I think, right?
No question it was hot. There's no question about that. Weather tonight is brought to you by Walgreens. And here's a look, first of all, at our Weather Watchers Network. And as you can see, temperatures started out the day on a rather warm note. Temperatures ranging from 65 degrees at Crossville to as warm as 71 here in Nashville and Paris, Tennessee. Over the last 24 hours in Nashville, here's the way we look. 94 the high, 71 the overnight low. No precipitation here to report. In fact, showers have been a little hard to find in our area today. Right now in Nashville, partly cloudy skies and 89 degrees. Relative humidity 55%. Southerly winds at 6. The pressure is rising at 30.03. Our air quality is in the moderate category. And the pollen is slight. Sunrise at 6.16 and sunset at 7.19. The National Satellite View now. A series of strong upper-level systems moving across Canada and the Great Lakes. One up here, the other one you can see, causing a lot of heavy rain, especially as these thunderstorms develop over parts of Illinois and Indiana. Some reports of 2 to 3 inches of rain. They're really quite common. Other scattered showers developing along the Gulf Coast, and as we look at the radar data, you can see where it's raining. Some heavy thunderstorms in Louisiana all the way down into Florida at this time. Looking a little bit further to the north, this cluster of thunderstorms has prompted a severe thunderstorm watch, and we expect a lot of thunderstorm development over Minnesota in the next couple of hours. As far as we're concerned, though, the activity is scattered over in the Cumberland Plateau and back into Arkansas and extreme west Tennessee. A few showers working there. Update the tropics. This is Tropical Storm Felix off the west coast of Africa, moving northward about 50 mile an hour winds. We're not concerned with that. Now, closer to home, overnight lows should be in the mid-70s for us, and it looks like tomorrow's high should be back into the mid-90s across a good portion of the southern U.S. About the only place where there'll be any refreshing change will be right along the Canadian border. Tonight's weather map shows a frontal system trying to move into the northern plains. I expect a lot of thunderstorm development to the north of us. That'll die out late tonight, and tomorrow morning, basically, that frontal system will remain well to the north of us, so no change is coming as the high-pressure cell remains right over us. And we'll have a look at that forecast coming up in just a minute.
These caring folks are Walgreens pharmacists, and here is one of their helpers. Working as a team, they give you up-to-date savings information. And with Walgreens 21st Century Technology, your current records are always as close as your nearest Walgreens. Concerned pharmacists. Superior healthcare technology. Only at Walgreens. For the right answer to back-to-school savings, come on over to Walgreens. Everything from kitty crayons to college theme books, all at very smart Walgreens low prices.
Tonight, hazy, warm, and humid, with an overnight low of about 73 degrees, southerly winds at around 5 miles an hour. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, a few isolated thundershowers developing, high of about 95. And that heat index will be up near around 100 again tomorrow, so take it easy. Low of about 71, southerly winds at around 5. And then on Wednesday, I think there'll be a few more thundershowers, but hey, if you really need it bad, I think I'd do a little watering. I wouldn't count on it. 93, the high temperature on Wednesday. The next 5 days, where's the relief from the hot weather? Doesn't look like it's going to be this week. A daily chance of at least isolated thundershowers, but no real change in temperature. Highs in the low 90s, low to mid-90s, and lows in the low 70s. Whew. Weather tonight brought to you by Walgreens.
We had a good rain at my place on Saturday, but the airport is reporting no rain fell.
I got a good one at my place, too, but it's all gone now. It evaporated in a hurry.
Pretty fast. Good. Okay, thanks, Ron. Now, let's check in with Bud Hedinger, who's here now to tell us what we're working on for our News Channel 5 6:30 report. Bud?
All right, Chris, thank you. Jim Baker doesn't want a plea bargain. He wants his day in court. Today, the PTL founder got it. We'll tell you what happened. Something's happening in Murfreesboro, and it is good for business. We'll tell you about MTSU's economic impact. And the president of Colombia has an angry message for America's drug users. We'll have the latest on the Colombian war on drugs, and in Telepoll, you'll get a chance to sound off about the president's option to send U.S. troops to Colombia. These stories and much more here on News Channel 5 6 o'clock report. We'll look for you then. Now to you, Chris.
Okay, thanks, Bud. Coming up next, Hope Hines and the sports. So stay with us.
Fighting muscular dystrophy is a team effort, and we're all important players.
We're inviting you to be a part of the UT Vandy MDA Challenge. Whether you're a Vols fan or a Commodores fan, your support makes everybody a winner. Muscular dystrophy is a dangerous opponent that can attack anyone at any time. So help us keep our guard up. Give to the Jerry Lewis Labor Day Telethon by supporting your favorite team in the UT Vandy MDA Challenge, September 3rd and 4th, right here on Channel 5.
You can send the laughter across the miles again. Oh, feels a good time starting. Oh, let the fun begin. Yeah. Hello, everyone. You've got so much to tell. Hello, everyone. South Central Bell. Cross the road, Jack, to a place with a taste that's more, that's more, that's
make it a fun day. Pick up a picnic pleaser for only $10.99. Enjoy 10 pieces of Kentucky Fried Chicken, large coleslaw, mashed potatoes and gravy, and 4 buttermilk biscuits at a picnic pleasing price of just $10.99.
Cross the road, Jack.
Well,
Kentucky Fried Chicken's got more.
Cross the road, Jack.
Hi, I'm Will.
My brother Barrow.
Yes, Lowe's is having a Labor Day sale.
All right.
You want prices? This all-weather storm door sale price is just $38.71.
Oh, you mean business.
Lowe's means business. With 50-pound bonus bags of concrete mix, at the special price of just $1.22 a bag.
That'll set you up in tech notice.
You'll notice Labor Day sale prices throughout your Lowe's store.
Do that slogan.
When it comes to the best prices in town.
Lowe's delivers.
Ventriloquism, Will?
Good guess, Barrow.
And our sports being brought to you by your Tennessee, Kentucky gold medal Chevrolet dealers.
So we're going to talk about steroids in the NFL,
oh,
right?
Oh, boy, I tell you, one of those happy stories that we always lead off with here, and Chris, it's almost like news these days, isn't
You've got to be a lawyer or pharmacist to report the sports. It's terrible.
I'll tell you what, the teams are going to have to check their rosters. They don't know who can play and who can't play yet. Let me tell you this. Approximately 24 NFL players tested positive for steroids in training camp and will be suspended for a month, the league announced today. Now, the names of the players who will miss the final exhibition game and the first 3 regular season games will be announced tomorrow. They were to have been released today, but the players' union blocked that, asking a federal judge to issue a restraining order to stop the league from implementing that suspension. More to come on that, obviously. Well, a total of 256 tennis players equally divided between men and women are in New York City for the start of the U.S. Open. Here we go. Defending champion Steffi Graf, the tournament's top women's seed, needed only 58 minutes to defeat Etsuko Inoue of Japan 6-3, 6-1, hitting 21 winners to only 4 for her opponent. Graf, by the way, has reached 10 straight Grand Slam finals and is expected to continue that streak. In the men's side, defending champ Mats Wilander of Sweden beat Austria's Horst Skoff 6-1, 6-3, 6-1. Wilander only needed an hour and 33 minutes for his victory. Brad Gilbert had his 17-match win streak snapped today by unseeded Todd Witzken. Chris Everett and Martina Navratilova play tomorrow. And by the way, John McEnroe, a winner today also. Greg Maddux tossed a 6-hitter this afternoon as the Cubs beat the Astros 6-1. They played at Wrigley. The win put Chicago 2.5 games up on Montreal in the National League East race, pending, of course, the outcome of tonight's Expos-Padres game. Astros now 4.5 behind the Giants in the NL West. And there's your score, Chicago 6, Houston 1. What a week this will be for Franklin's Darryl Waltrip. We'll have that story and more sports when we continue.
The biggest year-end truck sale in gold medal history is going on right now at your Tennessee, Kentucky gold medal Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Chevy trucks sure are beautiful.
With over 700 S10 pickups that must be sold immediately, no reasonable offer will be refused.
You're mighty right, son.
S10 is the big little truck that leaves Ford in the dust. With rebates up to $750 or 2.9% financing, pick up a great deal right now at your local Tennessee, Kentucky gold medal Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Don't you buy no ugly truck.
And yes, what a week this should be for Franklin's Darryl Waltrip. Saturday night, Waltrip led the final 205 laps to win the Busch 500 at Bristol. Waltrip now owns a record 11 career victories at Bristol, and this Sunday he will go for the Winston Million and the Darlington and the Southern 500. But tonight, Waltrip switches horsepower. His yearling colt, Ebony's Lumina Bay, competes in the yearling championship class at the Tennessee Walking Horse Celebration in Shelbyville. Lumina Bay already has won 4 times this season.
This is his horsepower, and I got my horsepower, and they don't mix too good. The only thing that I know that they have in common is they both take a lot of money keeping going.
Well, with what he's doing on the Winston Cup circuit, I think he could probably afford maybe two more horses. All right, in the 2 years that LPGA golfer Heather Farr has played in the Sara Lee Golf Classic, she became one of the gallery favorites. Well, 1 month ago, 24-year-old Heather underwent surgery for breast cancer, and now she needs our help. And Nashville has responded in a grand fashion. Tomorrow at the Hermitage Golf Course, the Heather Farr Pro-Am Benefit Golf Tournament will be held for Heather. 36 of her fellow professionals will be here, including Nancy Lopez, this year's Sara Lee winner Kathy Postlewaite, and Peter Jacobson from the PGA Tour. There will be a 1 o'clock shotgun start, followed by a benefit concert at the course tomorrow evening with country music stars performing, such as Mel Tillis, Gary Morris, Carl Perkins, and Vince Gill. And the sports have been brought to you by your Tennessee, Kentucky gold medal Chevrolet dealers.
Okay, Hober. Now, coming back up, we have something that could be a sports story, I guess, about the walking horse. Two friends, and they have a walking horse in common. We'll tell you all about it when we come back.
If you've got dental work, you've got three great reasons to chew Freedent. You know, Freedent won't stick to your dental work, and Freedent keeps your breath fresh. But maybe you didn't know Freedent moistens your mouth, too. So if you hate a dry mouth like I do, chew Freedent.
Freedent's the one that took the stink out of gum, and Freedent moistens your mouth. Yeah, moistens your mouth, and freshens your breath while you chew.
Non-stick Freedent moistens your mouth and freshens your breath.
Make the move to your Lincoln Luxury Dealer's official factory clearance. With 2.9 annual percentage rate financing or up to $1,500 cash back on Cougar LS or Mercury Tracer. $1,000 cash back on Mercury Sable and Topaz. Or get $1,000 cash back only on Mercury Grand Marquis. The official factory clearance. Make your move today. See your Lincoln Mercury Dealer.
Introducing McDonald's new country-style McChicken.
I grew up on those homegrown ways, a country-style, a down-home taste.
Where I come from, country-style means chicken like this. Juicy all-white breast meat, a crispy country coating, and real country seasoning.
I'm not swayed by those big city ways.
New country-style McChicken. Real country-style taste and a brand new way to love it.
That's where I come from.
New McChicken.
There's a different kind of paper towel. Two-layer thick coronet sparkle. It's absorbent, and it leaves virtually no lint on tile, no lint on food, no lint on windows or mirrors. When you use sparkle, you end up with something extraordinary. Something clean. Sparkle. All it leaves is clean.
More than 2,000 horses and their riders will enter the ring in this year's Tennessee Walking Horse Celebration, and two of the younger riders are from Ravenwood Farms of Franklin. Our Clifton Hunt found the young ladies share more than the same trainer. Through their horses, they have built quite a friendship.
Hi, girls.
Hello.
You won't hear any bells, but class is in session.
Just let the dog walk off a minute.
David Landrum of Ravenwood Farms trains walking horses and their riders. This morning, the students are Ashley Baker on Ginny's Jezebel and Victoria Martassi on Secret's Firefox.
Flat walk, Ashley. Just take your time, hon.
Ashley and Jezebel won their class at last year's celebration. In fact, Jezebel has won three different championships.
Ginny's Jezebel is extremely talented, but I've got an extremely talented rider. She has that little show presence that... I think the combination of the two really make a pretty picture, and I think that helps in the eyes of the judges.
Victoria plans to compete in the walking pony class.
They've had a learning process this year, and every time they go to the show ring, they seem to be improving, and between the combination of the horse and her, I think they got a real shot.
In the heat of the summertime, the workouts are generally brief. The girls work the horses anywhere from 15 to 20 minutes, then they hit the showers.
They each want to win their division, but at the same time, they're extremely supportive. It makes it really fun for us.
You looking forward to it this year?
Yes, sir.
A little nervous?
Very. I'm always nervous no matter what show I go into. I get nervous.
Each of the girls are strong competitors, but it always helps to have a friend nearby.
I forgot my earrings at one horse show, and she forgot her tie, so we just kind of switched clothes together.
That's fine now, but what happens when these two compete head-to-head?
Nothing for her. She beat me.
It's hard, but I mean, that bothers his friendship.
No matter what happens to these two in the show ring, they'll still be big winners. Clifton Hunt, News Channel 5.
And we'd like to wish those young ladies a lot of luck. They'll be showing tonight. And that's the 6 o'clock report. The news continues now with Bud Hedinger. Bud?
Thank you, Chris. Coming next on News Channel 5's 6:30 report, Colombia's president blames drug abusers for the all-out war terrorizing his country. Jim Baker's back in Charlotte, charged with stealing millions from PTL contributors. People in Franklin, Kentucky are steamed about a steam plant they thought would bring business but didn't. Those stories and new clues in the Music Row murder case. And Miss Piggy goes to Disney. The 6:30 report is next.
If domestic violence doesn't seem like a problem, have somebody who outweighs you 100 pounds hit you in the face. Give to the United Way.
Well, when I tell people that I work at a dating service, they typically have a lot of questions. And one of them always is, does that really work? That one never fails to take me by surprise. Matchmaker International has been in business since 1974. Thousands of people have gone through our program, and most of them are happily involved in dating. I mean, a great number of the marriages that you read about in the paper are our couples. So when I'm asked if it really works, the answer is always a resounding yes. Yes, it definitely works.
Let's party! You, me, Ernie, and 1 million dishes.
You know I love our little chats over a nice hot sink of big ivory bubbles.
Look at this dish.
You know what this is, Ernie? This is clean.
Rough? My hands? Yeah, they were a wreck. But that was weeks ago, before your Aunt Claire brought me ivory liquid. Now my hands feel soft, like Annie's.
Yes, Annie, I'm stunned myself. Is this country great or what?
Ivory liquid, where clean and soft go hand in hand.
Hi, Nashville. I want to thank you for making a break for the Pat Sajak Show here on Channel 5. We hope you'll keep joining us right after Entertainment Tonight for 90 minutes of stars, music, and, of course, the incomparable Dan Miller. That's the Pat Sajak Show, weeknights at 11 here on Channel 5. By the way, Dan thinks this is his show and I'm his little helper. Don't tell him anything.
This is the News Channel 5 6:30 report with Bud Hedinger.
Good evening. We're glad you're with us. Topping our news tonight, Colombia's president fires a salvo in the all-out war against his country's drug dealers. We have two reports for you. First, today's extraordinary appeal by President Virgilio Barco, which brought the drug war down to street level.
Those of you who depend on cocaine have created the largest, most vicious criminal enterprise the world has ever known. It has thrown us all into a war we did not ask for. We cannot rest until these cartels are brought down.
To that end, the Colombian military continues its raids on cartel strongholds, although none of the drug kingpins wanted in the U.S. has been found. But Eduardo Martinez Romero, wanted for laundering drug money, may be extradited to the U.S. this week. Many fear that could touch off more violence by the cartels, which blew up 10 banks this weekend in Medellin, Colombia's top cocaine manufacturing city. At least one person died in the bombings. These residents of the city planned to demonstrate against the drug cartels, but the bomb blast scared them off.
It is very dangerous to have a lot of people in this small square.
Tense times in the city of Medellin, and all this after President Bush's $65 million aid package to Colombia, complete with U.S. advisors. And there are rumors tonight that the president is ready to take covert action to stop Colombia's drug cartels, perhaps in the form of commando raids. Now, Les Hines is at the White House now and joins us with the story. Les, what about this possibility of U.S. covert aid?
But President Bush would neither confirm nor deny the possibility of a covert operation in that South American country. When asked this morning in Maine whether he had approved covert action, President Bush said if he talked about any covert operation, it would no longer be covert. Meanwhile, administration officials here in Washington say, despite reports to the contrary, Colombian Justice Minister Monica de Greff has not resigned her post because of death threats from the drug cartel. DeGruff is in Washington tonight meeting with officials from the Justice and State Departments. We're told by officials at the State Department that there has been no discussion of political asylum for DeGruff, despite the death threats against her and her family. Meanwhile, the State Department issued a new travel advisory for Colombia over the weekend, recommending that non-essential travel to that country be postponed.
I would note we don't have any specific threat against either official or private Americans, but given the heightened level of confrontation between the Colombian authorities and the drug traffickers, we believed it prudent for private U.S. citizens to avoid non-essential travel, just as the official travelers are doing.
Meanwhile, President Bush meets tomorrow in Kennebunkport, Maine, with Attorney General Richard Thornburg, National Drug Policy Director William Bennett, and other administration officials to discuss the president's national drug strategy, which will be unveiled next week. We're told that part of that will include stepped-up efforts to increase stiffer penalties for drug users in this country, which would address some of the concerns raised by Colombian President Barco today. Bud?
Well, Les, the Colombian government already has one drug figure in custody. Any word tonight on when he might be extradited to the U.S.?
Well, that's what Colombia's justice minister is here talking about tonight. The Bush administration views that as a positive sign and hopes that extradition can begin sometime next week.
All right, Les Hines in our Washington Bureau, thank you. As part of our ongoing effort to find out how you feel about what's going on in the news tonight, News Channel 5 introduces Telepoll, a feature that allows you to tell us what you think about issues in the news. A timely question certainly for tonight, should the U.S. send troops to help in the Colombian drug war? If you think we should, call 737-5000 to vote yes. But if you think U.S. troops should not be sent, call 737-5001 to vote no. A short beep on the line indicates your vote has been registered. The results of Telepoll will be given tonight at 10 o'clock on News Channel 5, and we will check in on your calls so far here in just a few minutes. From war-torn Lebanon tonight, a death threat against Pope John Paul. The spiritual leader of the Roman Catholic Church is said to be thinking about visiting Lebanon, but an extremist faction believed to be made up of Shiite Muslims is threatening to kill the Pope if he visits Lebanon on a peace mission. The legal crossfire has begun in a North Carolina courtroom where former PTL founder Jim Baker is on trial. Baker faces charges of diverting millions of dollars from his ministry to support a lavish lifestyle. A conviction on all counts could net Baker 120 years in prison and a $5 million fine. Today, the defense characterized Baker as a religious genius. The prosecution, however, couched him in more negative terms, referring to Baker as a greedy liar. Former Congressman Pat Swindoll must pay a hefty fine and spend 1 year in prison. Today, a federal judge fined Swindoll $30,000 and sentenced him to prison for committing perjury. Swindoll, a two-term Republican from Atlanta, was found guilty earlier this year of lying to a grand jury about a home loan he negotiated from an undercover agent posing as a drug money launderer. Swindoll claims he is innocent and plans to appeal. The fate of Hotel Queen Leona Helmsley is still in the hands of a New York jury tonight. Jurors deliberated over the weekend without reaching a verdict and still haven't come to a decision tonight. Helmsley is accused of evading more than $1 million in federal taxes. As many as five people are dead tonight after a plane crash in Lynchburg, Virginia. The small charter plane hit the ground amid patchy fog. The pilot and co-pilot of the plane were killed, as were three mechanics for U.S. Air. And in Washington, D.C. today, warnings about baby cribs. A group promoting crib safety warned today of cribs that don't have smooth corners. Most do, but the group says those with raised edges are unsafe because they're too easy for clothing to get caught.
Cribs have a long life. They get handed down, and many people don't know about this hazard. When you look at a crib, it looks safe, and it's so misleading.
Consumer Product Safety Commissioner Ann Graham says she knows of three infant deaths. Even though makers lowered the corner posts, it's still not level.
Well, there is the recommendation from the commission is if it does not meet the voluntary standard, get rid of it and get a crib that does meet the voluntary standard. And secondly, and more importantly, make sure that your child never has anything around his or her neck that could cause an entrapment, because it isn't just a crib post that can kill a child.
But the commission doesn't have enough members to make any decisions, at least not until President Bush names a new chairman. Coming next, more money for judges, a new theory on the Music Row murder case, and the latest on the man suspected in the murders of two Antioch women. We'll be right back.
We never thought it could happen to us.
But here we are.
Hey! Just like you, the Gradys never thought they'd ever win a sweepstakes.
But here we are.
Ready for full-tilt summer fun.
With windsurfers, dirt bikes, a Jeep, even a jet ski.
Register to win at your favorite store where you see the extra gold Coors and Coors Light display.
It sure changed our lives.
I am a jet ski mama.
Stretch your summer fun. Enter the extra gold summer stretch sweepstakes.
In an age when styles change with the seasons, one style's endured for over a decade in Lincoln Town Car. As 750,000 luxury car owners have enjoyed its timeless elegance and unmatched interior space, it's a big reason why 102,000 Cadillac owners have switched to Lincoln in the last 5 years. Now, for a limited time, your Lincoln Mercury dealer offers the last of these town cars with a special $1,500 cash incentive. Don't miss this classic opportunity. Lincoln Town Car at your Lincoln Mercury dealer.
Is it a murder mystery? It is a murder mystery, keeping detectives busy in Florida and here in Nashville. Police are trying to determine how a murder last Sunday in Antioch may be connected with the murder of another Antioch woman in Florida. Now, this is the man suspected in both murders. 36-year-old Alan Preston Brooks of Antioch was arrested Friday in Daytona Beach, Florida. Brooks is wanted for the murder of his former girlfriend, 26-year-old Amy Payton. Payton was beaten and shot to death last Sunday in her Antioch apartment. One day after Brooks was arrested in Florida, the body of 26-year-old Terry Lynn Bonds of Antioch was discovered in this Florida motel. Bonds had been shot to death and wrapped in a sheet. Police say she had been dead for several days. Now, Dan McDonald has been covering this story for News Channel 5 since it first broke, since the first murder last week. He joins us right now, and I want to ask you off the top here, Dan, is there any hard evidence now to connect one person with these two crimes?
Well, Bud, there is some evidence, perhaps more circumstantial than hard, but the vehicle, Alan Brooks' vehicle, was discovered in the parking lot of the same Florida motel where police recovered the body of Terry Lynn Bonds, which at least puts him at the location of the murder at some time and seems to suggest this is more than just a bizarre coincidence.
Well, Dan, what is the relationship then between Terry Lynn Bonds and Alan Brooks?
That's the big mystery police are trying to solve. At this point, they're not sure if Brooks and Bonds even knew each other, even though they're both from Antioch and they both have criminal pasts. Another strange coincidence in this story was Terry Lynn Bonds was arrested and charged with a bank robbery in Antioch. It's the same bank, Antioch Bank, where Amy Payton worked as a bank teller. Now, she's the woman that Brooks is accused of murdering in Antioch 8 days ago. So it's just another strange coincidence.
Yeah, it is complex, and I know there could be other suspects as well. And Dan McDonald, I know you'll keep us posted. Thank you. Also, News Channel 5 has learned that another murder back on March on Music Row may have been a case of mistaken identity. 23-year-old Kevin Hughes was shot and killed, and a companion of his wounded. Sources say the latest theory is that the bullet may have been intended for another man who looked like Hughes. In addition, the car Hughes was driving looked similar to the car of the intended victim. Police are still investigating the case, and no arrests have been made. A lot of folks in Franklin, Kentucky are steamed tonight at issue tax dollars used to buy an incinerator the city says never worked. As Shirley Washington explains, Franklin has gone to court to get its money back.
The $2 million incinerator can be seen peeking through a small field on the outskirts of town. A vivid reminder of Franklin's alternative to a landfill. The garbage-to-steam incinerator is supposed to burn trash for about $50 a ton.
The company said this facility, this incinerator, will burn 75 tons of garbage a day. And basically, the plant just wouldn't do that once it was constructed.
Bone says the incinerator burned itself up, leaving the community with nothing but ash. The city depended on this plant to help boost its economy. Officials had hoped to use the facility as a tool to lure new industry, leery of high landfill cost, and to sell steam heat generated by the incinerator to area businesses.
But those plans went up in smoke. The incinerator never attracted new business, and the city never found a buyer for the steam heat.
Court documents show Franklin is now suing the manufacturer of the incinerator, Cadu Incorporated, located in Germantown, Tennessee, for more than $2 million. The suit claims the company designed a defective incinerator that never worked properly.
We had to pay for the product $2 million. We've suffered damages because we didn't get what we bought, and the company should pay us back that $2 million. Plus the damages we've suffered.
Company officials declined to comment about the charges. In the meantime, Franklin pays a contractor to haul its garbage away while its two-year-old incinerator sits idle. The smokestacks are rusting away, and various panels inside appear to be disintegrating. It's all that's left of a dream that went up in smoke. In Franklin, Kentucky, Shirley Washington, News Channel 5.
This is Facing North Carolina. Oh, it's kind of small. We ain't got no picture show, no bowling alley. In fact, don't have much entertainment at all, except for old Wellwood and his harmonica. But there's one thing that we do have, and that's the Kate's Pickle Company. We pick just right cucumbers, fuss over them till they're the best tasting, best crunching pickle in the whole U.S. of A. Why? Because we got nothing else to do.
If you've been waiting all year to buy a new car or truck,
don't wait.
Now through Labor Day is your time to cash in on tremendous savings.
Do it now.
During your Ford dealer's great Labor Day sellout, get 2.9 financing or $1,000 cash back on Ford Ranger. Add an option package and save almost $2,400. Or get 2.9 financing or $1,250 cash back on Ford Bronco 2. Add an option package and you could save over $3,400 before you get your Ford dealer's Labor Day sellout discount. See him by September 4th.
To get the Ford deal of your life.
Hey, I'm really starved for something that tastes good.
Real good taste.
But low in calories, too.
Low cal, too.
Look, ta-da, Mr. Turkey.
Mr. Turkey is two times good for you.
With all the goodness of whole turkey, Mr. Turkey is up to 97% fat-free and low in calories and cholesterol.
Hey, great for the taste buds, huh? Great for the figure, too.
Real good taste, low cal, too. Mr. Turkey is two times good for you.
How am I doing? Well, how are we doing?
I think you're doing great. And you know, you came from Orlando, Florida most recently, and we got some Orlando weather outside just to make you feel at home. What do you
know, you really do. I feel at home already, and that's really thanks to the countless people I've met around Middle Tennessee. You folks are really nice, even you, Ron.
Well, thank you. That's very nice of you to say.
Hey, made it out to the Greek Festival this weekend and saw Chris out there and the Athena Fest. That was terrific. Good food.
I'm sure he didn't give you any discounts, did he?
No break.
Wouldn't give me any.
You indicated to me that I wouldn't be able to wheel and deal with the main man here.
Yeah,
and
that's great Greek food, though. No question about it.
Folks did a terrific job, and hey, we're still in the sizzle mode.
No question about it. Let's take a look at tomorrow's national forecast across the nation, Bud. We're looking at scattered thundershowers all from about New Mexico up through the Midwest and the Northeast, some showers in the Pacific Northwest, but much of the nation will again have sunny weather, including us. I think tomorrow will be another mostly sunny day for us. Let's check in with the National Weather Service radar now. Closer to home, some scattered showers and thundershowers from southeastern Missouri up through parts of Illinois and Indiana. Some of those have been rather heavy. There was, for a time, a severe thunderstorm watch up there, but that has now been canceled. Other scattered activity to the southwest of Nashville and over on the Cumberland Plateau. The satellite data shows that, indeed, most of the cloud cover today has been well to the north of us and extending down through parts of Arkansas. Basically, a sunny day for us and, of course, very, very warm. Temperatures are still in the upper 80s to low 90s across the region. The warmest spot looks like 93 back at Jackson, Tennessee, and we're at 89 degrees right now in Nashville. If you look at the heat index, well, it's very close to 95 to 100 degrees, especially back to the west of us, 103 this hour at Jackson, 110 the heat index up at Paducah, Kentucky. Here's the forecast for us for tonight. Hazy and humid, a low of about 73, southerly winds at around 5. Tomorrow will be a partly cloudy day, isolated thundershowers, that's it, and a high of 95, 71 the overnight low. And then on Wednesday, partly cloudy, scattered thundershowers and a high temperature of 93. Could be a few more thundershowers on Wednesday. Then look at that, 93 on Thursday, 91 on Friday, and 90 on Saturday. If you're going to be out tomorrow, take it easy because it's going to be another hot one.
Oh, my, good advice. Ron, thanks. In today's business news, there's an improvement in the nation's trade deficit. The Commerce Department says in the second quarter, the trade deficit narrowed to its smallest imbalance in 4 years. From April to June, the gap between imports and U.S. exports narrowed to about $28 billion. Sounds like a lot, but that's down 2.3%. The improvement stems from an increase in U.S. exports. Well, certainly no deficit likely at the Magic Kingdom. Listen to this. Kermit the Frog, Miss Piggy, and the rest of the Muppets are going to be teaming up with Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, and the other Disney characters for good. Jim Henson, who created the Muppets, is selling the characters, their film and television library to Walt Disney World. The price of that agreement is not known, but the deal does call for Henson to do long-term consulting and production work for Disney. Many towns throughout Tennessee are springing to life this week as thousands of college students return to classes. And in places like Murfreesboro, the influx of students also means an influx of cash. As Lisa Godley explains, higher education can mean millions of dollars to local businesses.
I'll be a super sure for fall and winter golf.
Ken Sloan has managed the Pig and Parsons specialty store in Murfreesboro for 20 years. During that time, he's watched Middle Tennessee State University almost double in size. He says that as the school grew, so did the community and his business. Roughly 20% of Sloan's customers and most of his part-time help are linked to MTSU.
Delighted to say that we use MTSU as a hiring facility. We employ right now 3 students from the university.
The hiring trend continues closer to campus at the Borough Bar and Grill. Here, anywhere from 10 to 15 MTSU students can be found working part-time. And like the majority of businesses in Murfreesboro, things prosper when classes are in session.
About 25% more people are in town from September to May than the rest of the year.
According to a recent study, last year MTSU generated more than $188 million, which went directly into the economy of Murfreesboro and Rutherford County. This year alone, with the student body continuing to grow, that number is expected to surpass more than $209 million.
The big numbers aren't just generated by students and faculty spending money in town. Visitors coming in for special events like ball games and concerts also contribute millions. And that gives merchants here an MTSU smile. In Murfreesboro, Lisa Godley, News Channel 5.
Great to hear news like that. And now let's take a look at a record high on Wall Street and some local stocks.
Designing women plus one Murphy Brown equals 5.
That seems fair.
Now, be on the lookout for 10. Count them, 10 of the funniest, most beautiful women on television.
Come on.
Who wants to look at ugly women?
With double episodes of Designing Women and Murphy Brown.
On a scale of 1 to 10?
It's a 10 for doubling your pleasure and doubling your fun. Get ready for comedy you'll get a kick out of when it's 2 Designing Women and 2 Murphy Browns, coupled with your other comedy favorites.
This is really good stuff.
Tonight on CBS.
Victoria Earp.
What? They finally found a substitute for the sweet roll. Hey.
Nutri-Grains Almond Raisin.
What is this, nuts and twigs?
Try almonds, raisins, and these great flakes made with brown rice.
But there's no sugar added. Earp, you're going to love the taste, even though it's healthy.
Hey, don't you have a story to write?
How's this? Man eats healthy food and lives.
The amazing taste of Nutri-Grains Almond Raisin.
It's news.
Follow the feline to values galore. That's CB Sweet Deal Line at your CB food store.
This week you'll find Peel Sliced Bologna, 1 pound package, $1.29. Tennessee Fried Sausage, 1 pound roll, $1.49. Medigold Square Carton Ice Cream, half gallon carton, $1.49. Register at CB for free admission to the U.S. Space and Rocket Center in Huntsville.
The sweetest deals you'll ever find are on that value beeline at your CB food store.
Bob Bartram, are you sure you're eating the most nutritious cornflakes?
I'd bet the house on it.
Amanda Pittman, are you sure you're eating the best tasting cornflakes?
I'd bet the family jewels.
You may not know it, but now there's a cornflake from Total. Total cornflakes have twice the vitamin and mineral nutrition of Kellogg's, and they taste better too. So before you bet on your cornflakes, remember, the best cornflakes are from Total.
Not often you get to sit in a studio with your boyhood idol, and here I am.
Hey, what can I tell you?
Hope
huh?
You're terrific. What do you got? I know we're starting the big U.S. Open two-week adventure.
We do indeed. I've heard about your tennis game, by the way. Your middle name is Love.
Yeah.
Right?
It ought to be on the tennis court.
Okay.
Disaster.
Let's see what happened today. Play began today at the U.S. Tennis Open in New York City. Defending women's champ Steffi Graf, a winner over Atsuko Inoue. And men's play, defending champ Mats Wilander beat Austria's Horst Stoff. And Chris Evert and Martina Navratilova will play tomorrow. By the way, John McEnroe will win today. MTSU officials are in the final stages of making plans to move the Blue Raiders game at Georgia Southern to a Thursday night, September 22nd, so that the game can be televised by ESPN. The game was scheduled for Saturday, September 24th. An NBA note today, the Philadelphia 76ers traded guards Maurice Cheeks and David Wingate and center Chris Welp to the San Antonio Spurs for guard Johnny Dawkins and forward Jay Vinson. All right, one day game in the majors this afternoon. Houston and Chicago both involved in a divisional race. They met at Wrigley Field, and there you have it. The Cubs 6-1 over the Astros. Pete Rose got double-crossed, he says. Rose feels he was tricked by baseball commissioner Bart Giamina because of the commissioner's public statement that he believes Rose bet on baseball. Rose also said today he did not rule out the possibility he might seek counseling for his gambling problems. Well, I wish I could say something truly profound about Pete Rose and his expulsion from baseball. I wish that I could write something that nobody else has, either in defense of or for his prosecution. While I believe Pete Rose is both good and bad, both a winner and a loser, my thoughts are now, what has the Pete Rose story meant to you and me? Because it is a story we all have taken part in. It has made us feel and think and react with emotion, most of us. Have we scoffed, laughed, made jokes, felt compassion, reacted with anger, or been saddened throughout the entire ordeal? If it's true what somebody once said, to understand the American way of life, you must study and comprehend the game of baseball. And friends, we have just been through a crash course. It has been a study of Pete Rose, both his great and legendary accomplishments on the field and his transgressions against the game he so passionately loves. Pete Rose, now a broken individual, and the game he played represents a passionate piece of the American way of life. What Pete does with his life from this point on either justifies his banishment or opens the door for his return. A nation waits for the outcome, for it is the American way of life that is on trial. So,
I'm with you on that. And Hope, happy to say your commentaries will be a regular feature here on the 630 Report.
And we will be back with a look at what you think about U.S. troops fighting the drug war in Colombia. Our telepoll results next.
Problems? We've got solutions. The real Yellow Pages from South Central Bell. It's here or nowhere.
Oh, what a headache. 3 states in 4 days. I need a vacation for my vacation. But I took 2 Excedrin, and I know I'll feel better. My headache's gone. 2 Excedrin, and it's gone.
When you want extra strength headache relief, take Excedrin, the headache medicine.
I'm ready to go again.
It's your thing. Do what you want to do. I can't tell you who to talk to. It's your thing.
Pearl knows in today's world there's no excuse for having only one pair of glasses, because now when you buy one pair with the Pearl coupon, you get a second pair free.
If families could always be together, dinners like these wouldn't be so special. Field makes every meal special with better tasting meats. We pack our Kentuckian hams in natural juices for better flavor. We slow-smoke bacon to fry lean and crisp. And we make sliced meats with fresher taste and only natural seasonings. As long as family dinners are special, Field will keep them that way. Field, the taste you've grown to love.
Now, before we update those telepoll figures for you, let's bring in Chris Clark, who is here to tell us what we're working on for News Channel 5's 10 o'clock report. Chris?
Thanks, Bud. A crackdown on the horizon for bingo halls across the area. We'll go to one place where that game is booming, but maybe not for long. Some important tests are underway. The city looks for a new landfill site, and we'll find out if you think U.S. soldiers should be sent to Colombia. And in our follow-up report, It's been 2 years since the Hawkins quintuplets made history. Tonight, we'll talk to the parents and the only surviving child. Those stories and more tonight at 10 o'clock, Bud.
All right, Chris, thank you. Should the U.S. send in troops to fight the drug war in Colombia? Telepoll update right now. 58% of you say yes. 42% of you say no, we should not. Phone lines remain open throughout the evening. We, of course, invite you to call, and we'll look forward to the final results here at News Center 5's 10 o'clock report. Now, for Chris Clark and the entire team, Bud Hedinger, thank you and good night.
A delicious chicken filet sandwich, a large fry, and a large drink. All for one special price. That's not a triple! That's a home run!
At some fast food places, the salad comes fresh
off a truck. While at Hardee's, it comes fresh off the vegetables. Hardee's Garden Fresh Salads, the natural thing to do to win you over.
Day in and day out, our customers tell us that we're giving them just what they want and what they deserve. Warm, personal service. That's because we made a commitment. Regardless of what happened anywhere else, at First American, banking was going to be a business of people helping other people. And that's a commitment we'll continue to live by.
If you've been waiting all year to buy a new car or truck,
don't wait.
Now through Labor Day is your time to cash in on tremendous savings.
Do it now.
During your Ford dealer's great Labor Day sellout, get 2-9 financing or $1,000 cash back on Ford Tempo. Add an option package and save $2,000. Or get 2-9 financing or $1,500 cash back on Ford Thunderbird. Add an option package and you could save over $2,400 before you get your Ford dealer's Labor Day sellout discount. See him by September 4th.
To get the Ford deal of your life.
It's good to bridge the distance. It's great to share the time. Just keep on looking forward to what you left behind.
Hello, everyone.
You've got so much to tell. Hello, everyone. South Central Bell.
Entertainment Tonight, weeknights at 10:30 on Channel 5.